너무 보여나가.
Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video I'm gonna talk about the spices and e-pass issue to Kolli Hills. In case if you didn't watch the previous Kolli Hills video of vehicles passing the dangerous 34th hairpin bin and riding through the complete 70 hairpin bins, I have given the link in description and iCard also. Do watch it guys. So everyone asked about the e-pass issue for entering the Kolli Hills. How did you guys manage to enter the Kolli Hills without e-pass? For your information, I had e-pass when I entered Kolli Hills. And do we still need one? Let's see in the video. That day, the climate was pretty good. We can see the decent amount of fog and mist in Kolli Hills. So after the long drive up the hills, we plan to finish the breakfast there itself in a small hotel. Due to the lockdown, the area was not much crowded and most of the hotels were shut when we went. In Kolli Hills, generally you can't expect the hi-fi foods when compared to other hill stations like Erkad Hill Station, Ooty Hill Station and Kothagiri Hill Station. But you can get regular foods in decent hotels. Most of them are small-scale shops owned by native tribal peoples. After finishing breakfast, we went to the waterfalls like Agaya Gangai Waterfalls, Masila Waterfalls. But all are closed and protected by police in each place for visitors not to enter. But Nammarvi Waterfalls is located on the way, was open but disappointed with this small water flow. That's okay, we took a nice bath there. Beauty is it was less crowded, which it usually doesn't look like that. We plan the trip to Kolli Hills on weekdays because the crowd will be less, and also here the police checking are liberal in weekdays. As we planned, we entered the Kolli Hills in another entrance called Mullukurchi Way, which doesn't have 70 hairpin bins. We exactly reached the entrance point at 6 o'clock early morning. So while we passing the check post, no one was there in the check post. Without any problem, we entered the Kolli Malai entrance and had an uphill drive of almost 30 kilometers to the main junction point called Senmedu. After that, we came to the main junction of Kollimalai called Semmedu, where you can buy all the spices which Kollimalai is famous for. So I just want to convey one thing for people who buy spices here. As far as I heard, in Kollimalai, pepper is the only plantation which you can see in all over the hill station. Next to that, some little coffee plantation. Next to that, some cocoa plantation. That's all. So here, spice shop owners in Kolli Hills will tell all spices you see are grown here. But that's not true. Instead, you can buy fruits like jackfruit, pineapple, guava, small hill banana, which is very tasty and famous here because they are grown organically. I'm sure you'll definitely feel the difference of the taste here in Kolli Hills. I'm not saying you don't buy spices here, but I'm telling all the spices are not originally grown here, as they mentioned. That's it. Here you can ask why we choose the another entrance to Kolli Hills instead of using the regular way, which is famous for 70 hairpin bin. Because the main entrance will always have checkpost, both police and forest officers might check. We hear this entrance is not that strict when compared to the main entrance, which I also show you in end of the video. So after buying some fruits, we can go down the hills via that 70 hairpin bin route. Come, let's go. If you want to see the full video of riding 70 hairpin bin, I have mentioned the link in description. Do watch it. After some time, passing 70 hairpin bends, we reach the forest checkpost here. Usually they will check every vehicles during the normal time, whether they carry liquor or drunk during the travel. After some time, we can reach the main entrance of Kolli Hills here. We can see the police checking the vehicles whether they having the e-pass or not. Yes, even now Tamil Nadu government has not lifted any restriction for entering the hill station. Please do carry the e-pass while coming to Kolli Hills. Otherwise, wait for some time. The government will lift the ban in some days so that you can come and visit Kolli Hills anytime. So I hope this video is helpful for you guys. So do subscribe the channel for more videos like this. Until then, bye-bye.